So mentioned number of times or according to the given condition, then you will get the desired results. So in see in the example, if asked in similar iterative method, then you mention the iterations five iterations. So we have to perform the five iterations. So these are the three iterations. They will do the partial pivoting of these iterations first. Then do the partial pivoting. So how to do the partial pivoting? What is the x1 coefficient? Larger x1 coefficient, that is 5. So this equation will become first. Then what is the x2 coefficient? Larger x2 coefficient. This is the final, this is the value 0. So this one will be the second equation, this one will be the third equation. So likewise this one. So after the partial pivoting, we formulate the equation in terms of x1, x2, x3 variables. So what is x1? X1 is equal to 2 minus 4x2 minus 10x3 divided by 5. So this is x1. So from this equation, x2 is this. From this equation, x3 value is this one. Okay? Then we start the equation, equation 1. In first equation, we have to assume x2, x3 as a 0 for calculating x1. So put x2, x3 0 here. You will get the value of x1. What is x1 we are getting? 2 divided by 5. That is 0.4. Next, whatever the new modified value of x1 is here, we put here. x1 equal to 0.4, x3 equal to 0. Then in this equation, we will get x2, 0.6. Then put the modified value of x2, x1, that is x1 to 0.4, x2 is 0.6. So then we get the x3, that is 1.2. So x1, x2, x3 values are 0.4, 0.6, 1.2. So after finding out this, the first iteration is going to be done. Okay? Then we go for the second iteration. For this iteration, what will be the value of x1, x2, x3? X1 will be the 0.4, x2 will be 0.6, x3 will be 1.2. So we put the x2, x3 value. In the first equation, we get the x1 value. So we put the latest modified value of x1 and x3 into the second equation. We get the x2 value. Then put the latest x2 value and the x1 value into the third equation. The equations are same. So we put the latest x1 value and the latest x2 value in the third equation. Here x2 is not present, so we just put x1 value modified. So what is modified x1 value? It is minus 2.48. So that when we put, then we use the x3 value. So x3 value is this one, 6.96. Okay, so x1, x2, x3 values we are getting. So equation second is completed. So this one. Again, we proceed up to the fifth iteration, the mention. So, third iteration, the new values of x1 and x2 are minus 2.48, 1.2, 6.96. So, that are the values. So, we proceed, put the x2 and x3 values in first iteration, we get x1 value. Similarly, we get the x1 new modified value, we put here in the second iteration, and x3 as usual, this one. Then we get x2 new value. So put the latest value of x2 and x1 in the third equation, we get the x3. So x1, x2, x3 values we are getting. So equation 3 is completed. So likewise, equation 4 is there. Equation 5 is also similarly to. Then after this equation, we will get the values of x1, x2, and x3. So one note is there in the last method, we are putting the latest value, of the variable, whatever we have calculated earlier. Means, suppose consider the x1 value is this one, so we put the latest value 1. Which one is the latest value of x1? Minus 56 is the latest value, this one. Okay? So earlier we have also calculated x1, that is minus 30, minus 2, but we are taking the latest value. So, take the latest. This one is latest, this when is the matrix quadratic in this one. Similarly, point 2, if when is the matrix minus 11, point 9 is the latest value. So the last middle method, the latest value of the variables you have to consider. For calculating the remaining value of the variable. We'll see the another numerical. So in this numerical, the three equations are there, and we have to perform the final equations, like the previous. So we will do the partial pivoting. How to partial pivoting? What is the larger coefficient of x? This one is the 2x, 5x, and x. That is 1. So if the 5 is the larger coefficient, so this equation will become first. Next, second variable is the large coefficient. Second variable, large coefficient. That is 3a. So which one is larger? 8 is larger. So this is the second equation. And then what is the remaining? This equation will become third. So first equation, second equation, third equation. After that, we have to formulate the equation in terms of x, y, z, in terms of variables. Then find x is that. So x variable, so x will be here. So 4.7 minus y plus z divided by 5. So this is the x equation. Then the y equation, similarly in the z equation from the third equation. Okay? So the first equation, y and z are the 0. So y equal to 0, z equal to 0. So if we put this in first x equation, we get the value of x. Put the latest value of x and z equal to 0 in the second equation, that is this one, we get the value of 1. Put the latest value of y and latest value of x in the third equation, we get the value of z. So put x equal to 0.94, y equal to 1.845, we get the value of z, that is 1.9685. So that means we have to put the latest value in the equation to get the new value of the unknown variable. So the second equation is similarly, we put the latest value of y z in the first equation, we get x. So latest value of x, so x value will get modified, that is 0.9647, and z as previously calculated. Input will get in second equation, we get the y value. So y value, this one is the latest. So ideal value is 1.845. What is the latest value? 1.3498. So we consider latest value. We consider the latest value. That is 1.3498. So this is the latest value, and this is the latest value of x. We put in the third equation, we get the value of z. Likewise, perform the equations, whatever they have mentioned. So, the third equation, similarly, fourth equation, and fifth. After the fifth equation, we are getting the value of x, y, z, and z. So, the next numerical of the bar figure that is based on the accuracy. Means the low equation definition only variation up to accuracy. If we achieve this, then we have to stop. So, similar like our usual procedure, previous example, if this is the first equation, second term, we'll do the partial pivoting. So, by partial pivoting, we are rearranging the equations, we are getting this one. So, 9x1 will be the first equation, then this 10x2 will be the second equation, and this one will be the third equation. So x1, x2, x3, these are the three variables. We'll get the equation for three variables from these three equations. So for x1, we'll get it from first equation. For x2, we'll get it from second equation. For x3, we'll get it from third equation. So for first equation, as usual, we consider generally, initially, x2 and x3 equals to 0. So we put this in the first equation, we get the x1. Similarly, x1 value and x3 0, we put value here, then the x2 value and the latest x1 value will put in the third equation, that is x1, the latest value, x2 is the latest value, so we will get the x3 value, that is -1.79. So this is the first equation, and similarly, do the second iteration. So after the second iteration, we have to check the accuracy. What is accuracy? Whatever the x1, x2, x3 values we have obtained in this equation 2, that minus the x1, x2, x3 values obtained from the first iteration, the subtraction. So you can see in the mod, x1, that is second iteration, x1 value, that is 2.95353. What is x1 value for iteration 1? That is 2.222. That is the subtraction of this, that is this one. If it is less than accuracy, then we will stop. They have mentioned the accuracy 0.001. So, this is greater than the accuracy, that means we have to perform the iteration. So, similarly for y1, we will check the accuracy, z1, we will check the accuracy. So, any of these will not get in the accurate. These all are greater than the accuracy, so we will proceed further. So, we will do the third iteration. Next, we take x1, x2, x3 values from the third iteration and the x1, x2, x3 values from the second iteration. So, subtracting of this, we will check the accuracy. So, here also accuracy we are not getting, so it is greater than, so we will do the fourth iteration. Then fourth iteration here you can see it is also the x1, x2, x3 values of the fourth iteration and the third iteration minus the letter. Then we will get the, it is showing that greater than the accuracy. So we will perform the fifth iteration. Here you can see the first x1 value it is greater than accuracy. X2 and x3 will achieve the accuracy. It is less than accuracy. That means x2 and x3 is the then we perform the next iteration, we will get the to get the x1 value. So here in the accuracy it is less than the less than given accuracy, so we get the x1 value is 0, x2, x3. Unless and until we are not getting the accuracy, we have to perform the iteration. Okay? So after the sixth iteration, we are getting x1, x2, x3. In x1, x2, x3 will be equal to 4. So I think these are maintaining situation. So this equation in x1 form, the second equation in x2 form, third equation in x3 form. Okay? So 5 minus x2 minus x3 divided by this 2 is equal to x1. Likewise, x2, x3 obtained from the second equation and third equation. So the first equation will assume x1, x2, x3 values are 0. So put x2, x3, 0 in the first equation. Then take the x1 value. Okay? Then next, put x1 equal to 0, x3 equal to 0 in the second equation. X1 equal to 0, x3 equal to 0, will get the x2 value is 1. Again, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, will get the x3 value is 1. In here, if you observe, as compared to the Gaussian method, we are not taking the latest value of the variable. So here, the x1 value is 2.5, but whatever the initial value, assuming x1 equal to 0, if we are not taking the latest value of the variable, we are taking the initial value till the completion of the iteration 1. If x1, x2, x3 are 0 for iteration 1, so we are not updating the values of x1, x2, x3, that is this value. So, for the next equation, we will update the value. For the next equation, we will update the values of x1, x2, x3. So, what are the values? X1 is 2.5, x2 is 3, x3 is 2. So, for the next equation, the value of x2, x2, x3 are this one. So, we will put in equation 1, we will use the x1, put x1, x3 into the first. Second equation, we will use the x2. So here you can see the x1 updated value is 0, but we are taking 2.5. Why? Because the previous iteration values. Okay? We are not updating the values in the current iteration. Okay? So the x2 value is 0.7. Next, x1 is 2.5, x2 is 3. So we change the value of x3, x3 is 0. So now, what are the new values of x1, x2, x3 for this iteration? That is 0.7. So for the third iteration, these are the x1, x2, x3 values. So in the completion of third iteration, we will not update the values of x1, x2, x3. After the finishing the iteration, then we will update it. Okay? That is the Jacobi iteration. So in the third iteration, we will see the x1, x2, x3 values. We put x2, x3, we get it. In iteration 1, we get the x1. So, x1, 0, x3, 0, we put in second iteration, we get the x2 value. So, we put x1, x2 in the third iteration, we will get the x3 value. So, now our x1, x2, x3 updated values are 2.15, nearly 1.825. So, for this iteration, these values, so updated values of x1, x2, x3 are these. So, the last fifth iteration, the values are, we are getting x1, x2, x3 as 1.8, 2.8775, and 1.65. So, the main difference between the Jacobi and Fiddler is that in Jacobi, we are not taking or we are not updating the values of x1, x2, x3 in the same iteration. We will update after the completion of iteration. But in case of Gauss Seidel, we are updating or we are taking the latest value of the variable. This means if x1 is the latest value, this one, so we will use this latest x1. So that's why we have Gauss Seidel paper. But here, we are seeing here, we are not updating the values of x1. After the completion of iteration, we will update the value of x1. Whatever we have got in the previous iteration, that is the Jacobi iteration method. So, because of this, the Jacobi iteration method requires the more number of iterations to get the accurate result as compared with the Gauss Seidel. Okay? So, thank you all.